Jay-Z is known for being one of the best rappers of our time, and also for marrying Beyonce, of course, but let's focus on the music. Hey everyone, I'm your host Jackie Adonisi, about to break down all the highlights of his music career right here on In The Loop. Sean Corey Carter was born on December 4th, 1969 in Brooklyn, New York. Writing lyrics and freestyling at a young age, he eventually became involved in street hustling while he tried to break into the music industry. After failing to secure a record deal, he created the label Roc-A-Fella Records with friends. Because if the doors aren't being opened, why not build the door yourself? The rapper released his hip-hop debut under the name Jay-Z in 1996. Following that was Jay-Z's sophomore effort was the 1997 In My Lifetime Volume 1. It was a very personal album and was recorded while he was trying to cope with the death of his friend and fellow rapper, the Notorious B.I.G. It debuted at number 3 on the Billboard 200 and produced the single Who You With. He came out with Volume 2, Hard Knock Life, the next year. The Grammy-winning record premiered at the top spot of the Billboard 200 chart, catapulting the rapper into stardom. This was thanks to singles such as Can I Get A and A Hard Knock Life Ghetto Anthem, which was the album's biggest hit. In 1999, Jay-Z collaborated with Mariah Carey on the number one single Heartbreaker. A few months later, his fourth album, Volume 3, Life and Times of S. Carter, hit the charts at number one and produced the commercially successful single Big Pimpin'. That year, Jay-Z also faced misdemeanor charges in a stabbing incident that eventually led to a 3-year probationary sentence. 2000 saw the release of the Dynasty Rock La Familia. It was another number one album and had a more soulful hip-hop sound. This record featured the hit single I Just Wanna Love You, Give It To Me. In 2001, Jay-Z and Nas began a high-profile feud in which the rappers disrespected each other through various methods. Their hip-hop rivalry was resolved in 2005. Jay-Z's next effort was 2001's The Blueprint. It was another record that hit the top of the charts. It also produced his first top 10 single, Izzo. The double album, The Blueprint 2, The Gift and The Curse, came out the next year and sold even more copies than the previous record. The number one disc yielded 2 huge singles. These were the commercially successful Excuse Me Miss and a duet with his future wife Beyonce called Bonnie and Clyde. 2003, the Black Album became Jay-Z's top-selling record of the decade. It fared well with critics and generated the Grammy-winning single 99 Problems, the top 10 song Change Clothes, and the top 5 hit Dirt Off Your Shoulder. The same year, Jay-Z held a farewell concert to mark his musical retirement, and the footage was later released as the documentary Fade to Black. However, Jay-Z returned to music in 2004, collaborating on the mashup EP Collision Course with Linkin Park. He also became president of Def Jam Records, though he left the company a few years later. 2006 saw the release of his comeback album, Kingdom Come. The commercially successful record included the top 10 single, Show Me What You Got. Jay-Z's 10th disc, American Gangster, came out in 2007. The number one concept album featured the single, Blue Magic. Though 2008, Jay-Z performed at many summer festivals, the most notable was his set at the Glastonbury Festival, which stirred controversy because he became the first major hip-hop artist to headline the normally guitar-oriented event. In 2010, Jay-Z, along with Rihanna and members of U2, recorded the charity single Stranded for the survivors of the Haitian earthquake. He also began collaborating with Kanye West on the EP Watch the Throne, which was released in 2011. While Jay-Z may be known for his rapping techniques, he is also a businessman who has his own management company, clothing line, and is part owner of the NBA's New Jersey Nets. Despite humble beginnings, he has gone on to become one of the most successful hip-hop artists and entrepreneurs of our time. All right, friends, now it's your turn to talk. Which one was your favorite moment out of his whole entire music timeline? Hit that comment section below. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe. Thanks so much for watching Entertainment Scoop. I'll see you guys next time.